Two hearts, one mind. That's the theme of this year's roadshow. Now, I believe that those of us in design and engineering already are of one mind. By that, I mean we're in a unique position. Of course, we're an integrated and key part of Rover Group, working for Dr. Walter Hasselkus. But also, we're in a very special situation within the BMW Group, because we are part of BMW Engineering, where we work for Dr. Wolfgang Reitzler. I believe that means we've already got two hearts, but with one mind. Now, many of you are already experiencing the joint and close working as part of the BMW engineering team. Regular meetings in Munich, developing new components for our products. Team gatherings here at Gaydon, testing of vehicles together as a team. Discussions, sometimes arguments, about the best solutions to technical problems. All of this shows we're now a healthy and vibrant engineering organization, working as one team. So how are we doing on our new products? Well, by now, I'm sure you all know that our next new product is the Freelander. Now, I believe we can be very proud of the work we've done on this car. We have a distinctive and exciting new Land Rover, which incorporates some very innovative engineering. So to those of you who worked on the project, congratulations. But is it good enough? Well, frankly, there's no such thing as a perfect product. And we still have much to do. We need to develop even more product distinction. We need to further improve the levels of reliability we achieve in our cars. And we need to improve the rate of progress that we're making on meeting the exacting quality standards of QZ. And all of that whilst controlling our costs. Now, to make rapid progress on this needs a very special and personal commitment from all of you. Every one of you, yes, you, each member of each function, must personally commit to delivering the highest possible quality in everything you do. If you don't, we may all fail. Now we must apply these lessons to our next projects. The L25, the next Land Rover program, the R40 large car, the new Mini, and a number of group powertrain projects are all progressing apace and are all at critical phases. So we have a huge opportunity to achieve the higher standards expected of us. So just in case you thought you were already busy, the months ahead are even busier. Now how, you might ask, will we cope? Now, many of these programs look very tight on time. We must, of course, retain high levels of quality and reliability in our new programs, but we must find ways of reducing costs. Our engineering costs are now too high, and we must find ways of reducing them through our upfront concept generation processes, our electronic virtual reality engineering. So how can we deal with all of these conflicting pressures? How do BMW deal with it? Well, they're adopting a new philosophy of engineering called re-engineering. So how can we help ourselves? Not only is our workload high, but the legislators are making life doubly difficult for us. Well, the solution is re-engineering. Now, re-engineering is not something to be afraid of. It is simply developing a new way of working with our BMW colleagues to reduce costs and to shorten lead times. What is re-engineering? The key ingredients are doing better upfront concept engineering by fully utilizing our electronic product definition facility, computer-aided styling and designing tools, computer-aided structural and crash simulation, analytical modeling techniques, the building of fewer expensive prototypes, fully utilising our laboratories in a cleverer fashion to accelerate performance and durability testing. Allocation of resources at the right time. And focusing on better quality. We are part of the BMW Group, and we must never forget that. But we must also remain proudly Rover. BMW and Rover. Two hearts, one mind. But above all, we must all become passionate about our vehicles, single-minded in their delivery, and obsessive about their quality.
Moss is ready. Record breaking's a new departure for him, except, of course, Grand Prix lap records, which he breaks with almost monotonous regularity. But he's one of the fastest men in the world when he's surrounded by other cars on a twisting circuit, so given a car that's as near perfect as research and ingenuity can make it, a flat, straight track, and no one else in sight, well, it should be a piece of cake. The officials are in their places. The timing equipment is ready. Conditions are perfect. And Moss is away. And from the moment the MG Special crosses the start line, it's obvious the old records are going to be smashed by a handsome margin. The only question is, by how big a margin? Record attempts, of course, have to be made with two runs in opposite directions, the official speed being the average of the two. This is the first run, and Stirling Moss's maximum speed is well over the 4 miles a minute mark. Nearing the end of the first run. Now, the decisive return run. One by one, the records pile up. 1 kilometer, 245.64 miles an hour. 1 mile, 245.11 miles an hour. 5 kilometres, 243.08 miles an hour. 5 miles, 235.69 miles an hour. And 10 kilometres, 224.70 miles an hour. 5 world records, all broken by about 20%, and 5 American records into the bargain. Veteran record breaker George Iston applauds the brilliant young man who has maintained the fine tradition that Iston and the MG experts began when Stirling Moss was a year-old baby. A tradition that has been built up by a blend of creative genius and painstaking labour. A tradition which has kept MG cars in the front rank for more than a quarter of a century. Yes, this is a great achievement, but the MG people are already thinking about the next. It's that refusal to be satisfied which makes the name of MG second to none in the world.
I did. When you told me the circumstances on the line, I said, I gotta do it for this guy.
Yes, I've got another one of these. The other one's gonna blow up here pretty soon.
What are you doing?
Opening a beer.
Okay.
You know, the stress of that luck of the weeks.
To get out here and do it in 4 drives, I think it's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. This is going down very nicely.